Hello everybody, and welcome to Mesmer Readabovs. Today I bring you an update on my Arcane Archer build, the Kaiser, my wisdom-based rogue falconer. It has been almost a year since my last video about the build, and back then I was 10 rogue, 6 monk, 4 fighter. I've made some changes to the level spread, and I am now 13 rogue, still 6 monk, and I've kept 1 fighter for an extra bonus feat and longbow proficiency. I don't think I get that from either rogue or monk. It is a bit tighter Kaiser builds. I'm beginning to feel a little bit feet starved. I have had to give up on the weapon specialization line I used to get from the fighter levels. So I'm a bit base damage and range power down. But I have increased the sneak attack damage with quite a bit. I had to fit in the improved sneak attack feat. So I've added 5d6s of extra sneak attack. I will try to keep this video pretty brief. Get to the point. So let's start off by taking a quick look at his feats. He is a half elf, so for his racial feat I chose the barbarian dilettante. And point blank shots. Next I took rapid shots. This I got from a fighter bonus feat. Then I took precise shots and Zen archery with a monk bonus feat. Precision with another monk bonus feat. I then took the rogue past life. And I had to choose a monk path as well. Here I just chose the dark path. It doesn't really influence the build. You won't have any key combinations. You only use your key for 10,000 stars. Then of course I took mini shots. And improved crit ranged. ...10,000 stars. This is your last monk bonus feat at level 6 monk. You get that around level 13, I believe. Improved precise shot. Improved evasion. Master of Forms for the critical multiplier in Fire Stance. Opportunist, this is another rogue special feat. And that was the heroic feats. For the epic ones, I start with overwhelming critical. Then I take combat archery. Holy strike. Improved sneak attack. Double shot. And dreamscape. This is random. A random buff. One of them is 30 ranged power. That is why I take this feat. But I don't always get it. But it's fun. It adds a little bit of randomness to the gameplay, and it's really satisfying when it procs and you make a new crit. Level 30 feat, Scion of Arborera. I focus on range power. I will maybe do some tests if the sneak attack one, I think it's the ethereal plane. I will do some tests to see what actually is better for the damage, but so far I've been focusing on the ranged power. And also at 30, I take Paladin Past Life for a bit more damage. Let's have a glance at my enhancements. Whoops. I've spent 14 points in the racial tree to unlock Arcane Archer. So down here I've gotten a wisdom upgrade and damage boost. And then I focused on my dilettante feat. I get 30 hit points from these three enhancements and some heal amp. And that opens up for the Arcane Archer. I then spend 41 points in my Arcane Archer tree for the capstone and the tier 5s. Rest of my points, I have 86 at the moment, so rest of my points go into the falconry tree. I'm not gonna spend any more points in this tree, and if I do get some leftover points from racial TRing, I'm gonna spend them in the harbor tree for more ranged power. My epic destiny is the Shiradi champion tree. I feel it's better for ranged combat than Fury of the Wilds. Fury of the Wild also has the Fury shots, but I get those in Shiradi too with Hunt's End. They are a bit slower, the cooldown is longer, but the tree has more going for ranged. For my twists I use Sense Weakness, Marshal Him, A Dance of Flowers, Enlightenment, and Rejuvenation Cocoon. One of the things I really did change on this build is the gear layout. I used to wear a four-piece legendary greensteel set, material opposition, for both hit point and critical damage bonus. But it occurred to me I could make up the damage with select items. So of course I'm some hit points down, so it's also a lighter Kaiser build. But I've managed to shift the damage from crits only to all my hits, so it's gonna amount to more damage in the long run. And I've actually surpassed the damage. And the beauty of this item set, I'll go over the gear in just a bit, but the beauty of this item set is I could take advantage of the new augment system. I can fit in two of the three-piece augment sets and some select augments here and there, some soul forged, the one piece. I couldn't get that with legendary greensteel as it doesn't have augment slots. And if I changed my gear to Feywild sets, then I wouldn't be able to get the augments as well, because it cancels each other out. The augment overrides the set bonus. So instead I tried to upgrade my stats via gear. I recently got Tharni's goggles that increased my deception from deception 14 to 18, so more sneak attack, and enhanced ghostly, which is a nice defensive buff. I'm gonna stay with the Shan ranged set, as I believe it's just jam-packed with the effects. I mean, I could get some of it from Feywild set, but this has everything I need except helplessness damage, which I work on augmenting with the three-piece set. So I stay with the Shan ranged set, and this is an improvement to my deadly item from deadly 14 to 17, and it also has Relentless Fury, which is a really nice damage effect. Armor piercing, I have that on my bow at the moment, the legendary Twisted Willow, But I aim to get the Feywild Raid Longbow. So it's nice I get to keep the armor piercing. Since I tried to get as much damage as possible onto my base damage, I started to use Litany of the Dead for the combat bonus, plus 4 profane to attack and damage. Legendary Cloak of Balance, I used that previously, even in my legendary Greensteel setup for the Insightful Seeker, so that didn't change. What did change was my belt. This is a Feywild item for Ramsmite, plus 2 to damage, and it's also my new constitution item. I have kept the legendary Ring of Prowess for the ranged power, and I really should try to grind out a better mythic version, but I feel that the longevity of this item is coming to an end. But 8 ranged power, that's hard to beat. Shan range set again with some nice mythic Reaper bonus. And this is a custom made Slave Lords item. I made it sheltering because I intend to augment MRR cap. So I'll go up to 70 points of MRR. And this will fill it. I have some magnetism on it because I use the electric stance mostly, so I try to improve a little on the damage there. Concentration, that gets me to over 100 key, 5-10,000 stars, and quality wisdom. My artifact is the dexterity one, because I feel the insightful stats are better than the wisdom artifact. Those are quality, but I get some of it from my helmet, quality deadly, so it was a double. So I feel the insightful, they help me more. It is somewhat the same bonus as I get from my deadly instinct over here, but at least I'll have it on when I'm not remembering to hit my deadly instinct. And I used the Project Nemesis braces for the deception and the double shot. And I upgraded it with wisdom. And my Shan ranged set armor. My augments are a little bit jumbled in there. I should redo my augment sets or my augments layout, because when I switch to my trapper gear, for instance, I lose half my spell points. So that could be done a little bit better. I'm also going to share with you today my sentient setup. I try to keep my build thread updated, but I'll just share it here in the video as well. Two-piece Deadly Rain, Long Shadow, two-piece, You can see I focus on ranged power. Wreath of Flame, 3-piece. It was an extra bonus. It comes from my raid filigrees, the 2-set ones. So it's just an added bonus, and yeah, fire shield. It looks kind of cool. Then I have 4-piece Spines of the Manticore, damage, deflect arrows, and again ranged power. Then 3-piece Crackshot Negotiator, 15 ranged power. And I try to get the individual filigrees as rare pieces, at least the ranged power ones. And my artifacts, I've loaded up with another raid filigree, 10 ranged power here, 5 ranged power, 5 more ranged power. But overall, I really like the improvements. Compared to my previous video from 1 year ago, I'm 25 points of damage up on the sheet and 15 to hit. And I mean, it's almost in every area I've improved the stats. The MRR cap. A bit more PRR. The only thing that hasn't really changed is my saves. They are a bit on the low side here on paper. But I find in actual gameplay with party buffs and in Reaper, it's actually quite decent saves. I could also, if I need to run through a trap, then I can use Wisdom Stance for a bit higher saves. But I'm mostly in fire stance for the damage. you can find my build on the DDO forums in the multi-class section of the classes. I try to keep it updated as I'm improving the builds. What I'm working on now is the augment sets, so I need to raid a lot, raid more, and I also need to farm some of those vessels. That's the main sticking point for me at the moment. I have currently 4 raid items in the bank that I need to convert to items, but I need those soul vessels. Okay guys, I think that's what I'm going to share for today. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments of this video or in my build thread, and I'll be happy to answer it if I can. Have a great December, and I wish you good luck if you, like me, do New Year's TR. This year I'm only going to do an epic TR. I need to be ready for the Feywild raid. There's a new longbow to be had. Anyways, see you later, guys. Thank you for watching yet again. Goodbye.